I recently added 4 Bamboo Lab P1S 3D printers to my business setup, so I want to bring you guys along for my list of the top 7 mods you can print, install on your P1S, and really take them from a default, out-of-the-box good printer to an ultimate, fully automated 3D printing machine. What's up, guys? My name is Sam, and welcome back to SamCraft. That's right, today's video is going to be my top 7 picks of things you can download and print yourself for free to take your Bamboo Lab P1S printer and really upgrade it. And it's exactly the 7 mods I've done to my machines over here and allowed me to honestly fully automate them for production. My first recommendation comes with a little disclaimer, being that I would only say do it if you print with PLA and PETG material. This is a top vent or a glass riser specifically designed for the P1S to get your glass up, allow airflow and heat to escape the machine when it needs to be, but also retain the glass there, hold it in place so that dust and debris doesn't fall into your printer and everything stays nice and solid. There are a ton of different designs out there, and the one that I have is super basic and super simple. I didn't want anything elaborate. I didn't need a fancy apparatus. I just wanted basically some blocks to lift the glass up, allow it to vent, yet hold them in place with my automated system, which actually tilts the machine. Upgrade number 2 addresses the actual nozzle area of the P1S and the fact that sometimes when your printer is changing filament or purging out filament, it can jump out of the little box. It can get some Klingons on the nozzle and basically have problems with poop. This product is known as the Nozzle Wiper. This particular version I installed is version 3.4. It is available on MakerWorld and linked down below, and is one that I have found works really well. The particular version that I like to install incorporates the Nozzle Wiper from an A1 machine, so you're going to need to have that on hand. Thankfully, Bamboo sells all sorts of parts and accessories, and it's affordable to grab, but it uses that in addition to closing off the area as far as the opening that the poop can jump back out of to give a very good result. I have had hardly any issues with filament strings coming back out of the bin after installing this mod, and my nozzle tips have remained a whole lot cleaner as well. Mod number 3 also is related to poop, and this is where exactly it goes or how it gets directed because it shoots out the back of the machine. Just like everything else, there are a ton of different versions out there on MakerWorld, but the one that I picked, I like for a couple of reasons. I like that it is a complete all-in-one print-in-place model, requires no support, it uses screws, physically attaches to the machine, and it shoots it off to the side. The way that I have my printer set up, they are largely back to back, so putting my waist behind the machine is not very beneficial for me. This side chute shoots it out the side and into a bin, which makes it super easy to just collect, change out my buckets, and keep everything nice and neat in my operation. The chute I did not design, but I did design a small little box that holds filament or allows the poop to be caught if you're interested in that setup. But I also have a different style poop box or container that I will show you in a little bit that is also linked down below. The next modification that I have recently found but really fell in love with is known as the AMS Flipper. This allows you to physically connect your AMS unit to your P1S printer and on demand flip it up and back to have access to the top of the machine. This is super handy, not only in the configuration that I have with the farm loop automation system, but just in general, being able to tilt that AMS back, pull that glass off, do whatever you need to do inside and put it all back together without disconnecting wires, without disconnecting PTFE tubes, and without needing extra space to store or hold that AMS while you do that work, worth its weight in gold. This is also a great file. It prints super, super easy, very strong and robust, and one that is really, really nice. All right, you guys still with me? That concludes all of my must print mods. No matter if you're using your printers in a farm setup like this, or you just have one in a space in your house, I definitely recommend you print and add all those to your machine. Now let's talk about automation. So the system I've installed is made by 3D Farmers, and it is called their Farm Loop system. I've installed their system on my P1S machines, but they have it for the X1 series, the regular P1 machines, and the A1 and A1 minis as well. For the P1S, their kit consists of a bar that goes across the front, down at the bottom, with two little arms that go up and flex the plate according to its coating. You then have two little bed clips that go to the back to keep your PEI plate in place as it's flexing. And the last thing you have is a pusher blade that clips on the front of your hot end and allows it to push your materials off your printer. The core components will change based upon the P1 and the A1 series. So definitely check out the links below if you want to see what it looks like for your machine. All of this stuff you can download and print for free from MakerWorld, but the really good benefit, and actually what makes this work, is the software that they also offer. I'm gonna have a full video talking about Farm Loop later as I get a lot more experience with it, especially across other machines in my shop. But to summarize their software, you upload your file, you tell it what kind of machine it is, and what parameters you want for cooling, how low to let that temperature on the bed go, or how long to wait before it then goes through its pushing or prying cycle, depending upon your machine, and basically unloads your printer to prepare it for the next job. You can also choose how many loops to create, which is basically how many times to repeat your job, which is where they get the term loop in Farm Loop from. I'll have a dedicated video about Farm Loop a little bit later. I want to get my feet more wet with this system, but I also want to incorporate their system into my Bamboo Lab A1 printers to give you the best kind of overall presentation, how it works, the good, the bad, the ugly, and everything like that once I have time or miles on the vehicle. So let this summary suffice for now, but if you're interested, again, check out Farm Loop 3D Farmers channel or stick around here for my video coming up pretty soon. Once I converted my P1S printers to the Farm Loop system, all the machines were now tilted, which made me redesign my poop bucket. That was easy enough though. Even my limited skills could come up with an angled poop bucket. And so that's what I designed, printed out a handful of them here. And I made sure that the angle on that poop lid matches the angle with the side chute. And it, to me, looks pretty good. That poop bucket will be down below if you wanna check it out. It's a free MakerWorld file. You know, it's a box, right? I'm not breaking any molds here as far as design skills. But I figured I'm using it, I'm showing it. There's the file. If you want to have yourself an angled poop bucket, you can by golly have one too. And last but not least, at mod number 7 are the little arms you see on the front of my printers that are holding plastic totes. It may be simple, it may seem like something that's interesting or not, but those little guys, hands down, are wonderful for functionality, but also keeping my space clean. Every time the printers are done and they go to push the file off, you gotta have somewhere to hold it or catch it. For a while, I had some boxes stacked up to catch it, but that became cumbersome, didn't look very good, and well, we could do better. The inspiration for these arms came from the 3D Farmers school community, and someone else had posted a version that they came up with to go on metal shelves, but I have wooden or plywood top shelves, so tweaked it, made a little bit different, and made my own version with wooden screws to attach it to the tops of the wood. These are designed to work with a specific Sterilite name brand clear tote, and so those are also linked down below, but I was able to get them from Walmart. I believe the person who made the first version got theirs from Menards, I think, and so hopefully they're pretty universal. Overall, they're very easy to print out, very easy to assemble, and look great, but function even better. There you have it, guys. There are my top 7 mods or things to print and install to the P1S printer to get the most out of it. I'm curious, did I show you anything new? Did you already know about this? Am I missing something obvious in my system that you know would be really good to add? Leave me a comment down below to let me know. Also, let me know if you've ever come across automation systems like this before. The Farm Loop is one that I've run across. In addition, there are some other plate swappers that actually physically remove the build plate and load another one in. I'm planning on testing those. This is the one I chose just for now because of the very low bar or entry level, not a lot of real estate taken up, not a lot of plates you need, but it does have its limitations. So in the meantime, as I work with this more to get my full video for you guys, let me know if any other automation solutions that you know of that are out there for the P1S or the A1 printers. Those are the majority of the two that I have in my shop. Either way, I appreciate you guys watching as always. Take care. I'll see you guys next time in the workshop.